What you just saw is something that every older Minecraft player knows what it is when they see it. To the naked eye, it just looks like someone making a world, but to an older player, a wave of nostalgia just overflows them. Whenever you think of old Minecraft, what comes to mind? Do you think of old content creators, playing multiplayer with your friends during the summer, or even just playing on a single player world? Now, if you ask me that question, you'd get a response that isn't really that much, and that was when my Xbox 360 would glitch and send me to one of the older title updates.
Oh, brother, this guy stinks!
Okay, I know that isn't the best way to say it, but I do remember watching people like Stampy, DanTDM, and Sundy when I was younger, and they would always make my day better, but that's besides the point. I'm going to talk about something that has recently had an uprise in the Minecraft community, and that being the eeriness of the alpha through beta versions of Minecraft. Okay, so first off, we have to think about what makes old Minecraft so eerie. So with our first example, we will start with darkness. Back in the older versions of Minecraft, a brightness setting was never implemented and you had to rely on your computer's brightness. But even at max, it's still very hard to see. So what I do is make charcoal from wood so I can get torches without taking a gamble on finding a colony cave with no light. Now, the part that makes it eerie is that at some point, everyone has been afraid of the dark. I mean, I still am to this day. But the feeling is from the fact that although you are alone in the world with no other players to accompany you, that doesn't mean that there isn't something with you in the world, which is why I get scared when a creeper jump scares me while I'm mining. Now, of course, there actually isn't something in the world with you unless you're a fucking ARD protagonist, but in the back of your mind, you still think that there's something out there. Now we end up this category with our next, loneliness. In Minecraft, there weren't many mobs. From what I know, for friendly mobs, it was the pig, sheep, and cow, and for hostiles, the spider, zombie, and skeleton. Now, I may be wrong, but those are the ones I have encountered during my time playing beta Minecraft since I've recorded gameplay for this video, as you can see in the background. Now, the sense of loneliness someone can get from beta Minecraft is similar to the feeling you get while you're playing a source game. Take Gmod or TF2, for example. You load up into, let's say, an empty 2-4 server, and even though there's ambience to make it seem like there are creatures there, there's really nothing but you in that map. The lack of mobs is what gives the player the feeling of loneliness, and occasionally the game will begin playing one of its background checks. And also, the game also has a lack of ambience. The only thing you would hear is the loud and sorrowful croaking of the caves under the surface. Take a listen. Yeah, pretty horrifying when it plays at the right time. And now, for our third and final point for this video, liminality. The liminality of beta Minecraft is another driving factor of its eeriness. Take this scenario into account. You're strip mining or traveling a long distance. That is the sort of transitional space in Minecraft. You want where you want to go, but you aren't where you started to begin with. This is also how some players can drive some of that nostalgia from beta Minecraft, such as people remember taking long mining trips or traveling long distances. Something I can infer to for transitional spaces are some of the corridors in Half-Life. You aren't where you need to be, nor are you where you just departed from. Take the hallways of Optics Complex, for example. Your goal is to leave Black Mesa, which is where you're going, and you let from the Sector C section of the facility, which is where you just departed from. To sum it all up, it's the space between point A and B, which is something that we do all the time in our day-to-day lives. In conclusion, Beta Minecraft is nostalgic, yet eerie at the same time. I hope all of you enjoyed this video. I'd extend it if I had to, or if I wanted to, but I have to get back to working on my school stuff tomorrow, so please, if you can, leave a like and subscribe if you enjoyed the video, and I'll see you in the next one. Have a good night.